Hey everybody, Netta Marie the Doula here with another new doula story. Because of course I have so many of them, being that I am a new doula, trying to just get it all out, just let doulas, new doulas know like it is okay. I don't really know necessarily everything, but I hope that this vlog helps new doulas to be inspired, to keep going, even though you don't know, even when things don't go as planned, like what I'm about to tell you. So, I am called, right? I have a mom that's due. She's in labor. She's been laboring at home. She's doing an amazing job. Dad is supporting her. It looks awesome. They're doing great. They're, you know, implementing the different moves that I showed them in our prenatal session. So, it's going great. So I get a phone call the next morning and they say, we're at the hospital. So I'm like, okay, cool. So at that moment, I'm like, all right, how many centimeters is she? He says 7. At that moment, I think what went through my mind was one of the doula taboos that we often pray does not happen, but we know is a possibility, right? So I'm like, okay, 7 centimeters. The hospital's a good, I want to say the hospital's a good 30 minutes from me. And I also have to get ready, right? So I got all my like stuff together, my bags packed, all that is no biggie, but I have to handle home. Like I have to get things together, all of that. So I always tell my families, like, I'm going to at least take an hour. It's going to be at the most, I mean, at the least, I'm going to be there an hour, you know, like, because I try to get out the door and just get there. So I'm like, I already know I'm like 30 minutes from the hospital anyway, and I have to try to get moving. So I'm like, all right, I'll try to be there less than an hour, but I know I'm at least going to be an hour. So I get there and I'm like, I drive there and I get to the parking garage, and because this hospital has like new structures and things like that, I'm like, okay, what garage do I go to? Doula tip number one, know where you're going. Like, that is something to be known. Like, know where you're going. Know exactly where you're going. Even if you think you know the hospital, which in that case, I thought I did. Know where you're going. Even, like, go there first and, like, figure out how to get there, whatever. Doula tip number one. So, moving along in the story, I go to the garage, I get out the car, I'm there. It took me about like a good 40 minutes to, like, you know, get there. So I thought I was like doing great. I was in perfect timing. So I get to the hospital, park, get out the garage, because for some reason I was having trouble with the ticket printing machine. I mean, at the craziest time, you have problems with a ticket machine. So I'm like, okay, whatever. I'm woo-signed because, you know, it's no point in being anxious. Why do you be anxious, Netta? So I'm having problems with the ticket thing. I'm like, okay, I got through that, whatever. I get out my car, I rush up there to the counter, and I'm asking them the number because that sent me the room number and everything. I'm like, great. So I have the room number. I ask registration. I'm like, hey, do you know where this room is? And they say, I knew something was wrong when she pulled out the map. This lady pulled out a map. I said, Lord, I'm at the wrong building. I'm at the wrong building, Lord. Okay. So I'm like, so she's talking. She was like, look, now you can do one of two things. You can walk, and she, like, you know, it's about a 3-mile walk, like a 3-block walk, or you can drive. So I said, okay, well, you know, let me know. You know, show me on the map how to get there walking. She drew so many turns. She said about 2 elevators, an escalator, and I don't know. By the third turn she told me, I said, that's okay. Like, I'm okay. Like, I'll drive. So I'm like, all right, well, she was like, all right, well, you're just going to look for this building sign. So I get in my car. Now I'm like, okay, that took about a good 10 minutes. So I'm like, oh my gosh. My spirit was like, this doula taboo was about to happen. This doula taboo was about to happen. I feel it. So I'm like, okay, calm down, Netta. I'm like, so whenever I'm like feeling a little anxious, I start breathing really, really deep because I know that nothing gets accomplished when you're anxious. So I'm like, okay, Netta, let's calm down. So then I'm like, all right. So I'm driving. Now, between that garage and the other garage that I need to go to, it's like 5 lights. Now, why do hospitals have 20,000 lights in between each door? I don't know. And I really want to write them and talk to them about that. But anyway, so I'm at this red light for hours, it felt like. I mean, it probably was only 2 minutes, but I can be dramatic. So I'm like, okay, I'm at this red light. All right. So in my head, I'm like, Lord, she done had this baby. She done had this baby. I feel it in my spirit. She done had this baby. So I'm like, it's okay. It's all right. By this time, I think it's like, let's see. It had to been about 7:35. I want to say 7:35. Mind you, I probably got to the hospital about 7:20. So, yeah, because it took 10 minutes to talk to the receptionist. Yeah, so it's about 7:35 now. So I'm like, all right, cool, whatever. Now to just be positive, like, you're going to make it. So I'm driving. I get to the garage. I find parking. I park. And I'm like, okay, how do I get to where I'm going? So I'm like, all right, do I need to walk out of here? Do I need to walk upstairs? Like, what do I need to do? So I finally get inside of this part of the hospital. And I go upstairs. I go upstairs and I'm talking casually to a resident because can't rush the elevator. So you might as well take some time off and just, you know, talk. So come to find out, we're going to the same place. Not necessarily the same birth, but the same place. So I'm like, okay, at this moment in time in my head, I'm like, Netta, why do you have your bag? Like, why do you even have your doula bag? She already gave birth. Like, this is what I'm telling myself. I'm like, Netta, she clearly already gave birth. I don't even know why you're taking it. So I'm like, okay. I get to the room and I knock on the door and they say, who is it? So I was like, this is Netta and this is the doula. And I open the door. They was like, come in. I open the door and everybody, it's like 5 nurses by me, like by the door. So I don't know if anybody else understands the way the delivery room works, but if it's a laboring mom, if she's like in transition or she's like about to like give birth to this baby, the nurse is not going to be at the door. Like, not that many nurses. Maybe 2 of them back there ready prepping for the baby, but everybody's not going to be at the door. So I was like, this isn't good. Everybody's standing at this door. This isn't good. So I was like, okay. So they were like, who are you? And I see another woman who isn't like in any nursing uniform or anything like that. So I was like, oh, this must be family. And I'm like, I think I missed it. So they was like, who are you? And I was like, I'm the doula. And I know I probably had the weirdest expression on my face. And they were like, oh. And I was like, oh God. Here I am, backpack on, ready, doula shirt, you know, like all up ready for this. And she already had the baby. I walk in, clearly they're still looking at me like, why are you here? I walk in and the mom is laying there doing an awesome job, of course. Like, oh my gosh. She's laying there, baby's on her chest, she's birthing the placenta. At this moment, I realized I was not taught anything about this part. You know, in any type of training, any type of conference, nothing like this. Nobody has ever told me what happened when they have missed a birth or if they have ever missed a birth. So this time I'm questioning what I should do. I'm feeling defeated. I'm feeling like I let mom down, all of that. So I'm like, okay, Netta, fix your face first of all, because this ain't got nothing to do with you. Like, this ain't about you. It's all about mom. You made it, so that's great. You made it. Good job. So I'm like, okay. Mom's still sitting there. I'm like, oh my gosh, you're doing such a great job. Mind you, her nurses and doctors and stuff are there, which might I add was bomb. Like, oh my goodness, the best team ever I've ever heard of, seen, whatever. Like, yes. So I knew mom was well taken care of because dad was already, you know, doing amazing work at home when she was laboring at home. So I knew it was nothing. It wasn't going to be anything short of amazing. So the birth is over, you know, mom births a placenta. I stay there, you know, because I'm not gonna leave her. I'm, regardless of how I feel, I still made it, and mom is still there. So I'm still in full doula mode. So, but I'm like super, super sad. Like, I'm like, oh my God, I straight missed his birth. Like, I was like, oh my God, I'm a horrible doula. Like, why am I gonna do that? So I'm like, okay, Netta, get out your head. Like, just see what mom needs. So anytime after mom's delivery, usually I go over like breastfeeding things, make sure she has a good, make sure baby has a good latch, all of that, making sure that she's good. So everything is good, you know, all of that. So I'm feeling like I need to go ahead and just step out, like go. So I leave and my heart is heavy. So I've already asked mom, like, you know, how did you feel? Oh my goodness, you got what you wanted. I'm so proud of you. Like, I definitely made sure that I amped her up, that I amped dad up, because she really did do an amazing job. Like, she got it, the perfect birth, everything she asked for, she got. So I'm really, really proud of that. I was just in my own head. So as a doula, talking to other doulas, I'm talking to you from a doula perspective of when you miss a birth, how that feels. Like, it felt horrible. I felt like I had just let everybody in the world down. All of this quote-unquote practicing I felt like I did, and I did with the family, I felt like I let them down. So I didn't understand. My head was just everywhere, and I was so sad. And so normally, like any other birth or after a birth, you do a follow-up session with mom. Well, mom is like, not really, she don't really necessarily feel like she want a follow-up session, which is normal. Like, some moms feel like they want one, some moms don't. You let them, you know, you let them do them. That's why you go over postpartum, like, precautions and safety measures and stuff, like, before the birth. That way, if you don't end up meeting with mom after the birth, it's no big deal. Like, you know what I mean? Like, you can still check in with her, make sure everything is okay. But, like, talking about, like, preeclampsia after birth, and about blood pressure, and about, like, postpartum mood disorders and things like that, you talk to, for me, I talk about it throughout the time. And then I talk about it after the birth, you know, around the breastfeeding and stuff like that, just so she can know that reach out anytime. But as a doula, you know, I felt like I let her down. And I was super, super sad. But I learned something from that, you know. And so I'll talk about, like, everything I learned from it in another video, but I just really wanted to get that off. But, like, so one thing I will say is, like, you cannot beat the clock. Like, you can't beat nature, like, at all. I don't care who you are, how planned you are, how fast you are, you can't beat nature. So I just wanted to get that off my chest, because that happened to me, the biggest taboo I think that any doula may ever consider, you know, happened to me at my previous birth. And I was just like, oh. But kind of find out, mom had the birth that she wanted. And I had to remember that. But I'll talk more about what I learned from this birth, how I grew from this birth, and give you all some tips on, you know, if this should happen to you, how to nurture yourself back to wellness, how to nurture yourself back to being a badass doula like I know you are. All right, guys, see you in another video. Thanks for listening. Peace.